Speed killer most of us buy at the store could lead to devastating long-term effects.
Many weed killer sprays contain a chemical called glyphosate. Doctors link it to cancer. Environmentalists say it's killing our water quality as well. So NBC2's Joe Petrello put a safer, homemade weed killer to the test.
In an abandoned Lehigh Acres golf course, a group of farmers have found purpose.
In that role, we actually donate a lot of the produce that we grow here to local food pantries also.
Jorge Acosta keeps Healthy Harvest Farms healthy. He grew up in Lehigh and is now helping his hometown fight hunger.
So when I'm able to donate produce to the community that I grew up in, it actually feels really good.
A vital part of his job, keep the weeds out.
They drain a lot of the nutrients from the things that we actually want to grow, like food.
Jorge has a lot of ground to cover, but instead of spraying chemicals, he'll cover the weeds with plastic tarps and leave the rest to the sun.
It actually solarizes the weeds, and in about 4 to 6 weeks, it burns them up.
I wanted to get a second opinion for you, so I went to Florida Gulf Coast University to speak with Dr. James Douglas.
I got my PhD in marine science at the Virginia Institute of Marine Science.
Dr. Douglas focuses a large portion of his studies on plant life.
There's really no technical difference between a weed and any other plant. It comes down to the way that we view them.
He says if you don't like weeds in your lawn, the most environmentally friendly thing to do is pick them out yourself or just let them grow.
Let's view them as beautiful wildflowers and cherish their unique diversity.
Jorge, however, disagrees.
A lot of the weeds here are invasive. Hand pulling of weeds, we try our best not to because it just takes a lot of time.
But what if you're just a regular homeowner? You don't have a farm, you have a yard, and you want to keep the weeds out. Well, that's where this homemade spot treatment comes in. Here's what you need. A quart of vinegar, 2 cups of Epsom salt, and 1/4 cup of dish soap. Mix them all together in a spray bottle and give it a good shake. But does this work as well as the store-bought stuff? We put it to the test.
On the left side of this time-lapse video, we sprayed the weeds with our homemade concoction. On the right, we sprayed using the professional weed killer. Both killed the weeds and let the grass live.
The best time to use your homemade weed killer is on a day like today, while there's some sun outside. But it is rainy season in Florida, and it did rain during our experiment. Still, I'm happy to say that it worked. Now, if you want to try it out, we have the whole recipe laid out for you on our NBC2 app. In Fort Myers, Joe Petrillo, NBC2.